Hearing the words, "You have cancer," felt like my life was being hijacked. I saw my children's lives pass before me without me. As I travel this road, what has surprised me most is how strong I really am and how many people love and support me.
Jack, Brady, Kate, and Maggie Mae. Tonight, Mommy walks for you. About breast cancer.
Come on, baby. You've got a warrior for a heart. Don't you dare stop fighting. You will rise. You have the responsibility to the rest of this world to do so. Don't you dare forget that you've got women and the rest of this world watching you. Show them that pain is not the end of things. Remember that you are more than the breasts your mother gave you.
A lot of these females, at one point or another, had lost confidence, had lost self-esteem, had stopped feeling beautiful. And what we wanted to do was put them on the runway and make them stars, the stars that they deserve to be.
This isn't just come to a fashion show, donate some money, bid on some silent auction things and go home, and you have a tax write-off for the year.
I didn't want to just produce an event and say, here was the benefit and I'm off.
I wanted to be able to tell the story of survivors and make people cry. And then I wanted to make them laugh, you know, and then I wanted to make them cry again, because that's the journey of breast cancer. The We Believe Foundation started 5 years ago when my son Matthew got testicular cancer. He was 17 and a senior in high school. And fortunately, he battled through this disease and is in remission. And so we're really happy about that. But in the process, we began the We Believe Foundation to help teens and young adults battling cancer. We started in the lacrosse community because my son was a Division I lacrosse player at the time. But in the process of doing that lacrosse event, one of the moms, who is a good friend of mine and a big supporter in our organization, was diagnosed with breast cancer. And unfortunately, a really aggressive kind of breast cancer. She really wanted to give back to young women battling breast cancer. And so that's when Pink Hearts of Hope Fund started. We wanted to do something bigger. So we reached around and we actually asked one of the largest salons on the East Coast if they were interested in doing something with us as well. And Robert Andrews Salon and Spa said, yes, we really do want to do that. And so now we had our presenting sponsor. And they wanted to do a fashion show that focused on hair. And, well, I'd never done a fashion show. And so I was, what am I gonna do?
We were approached by We Believe Foundation to put on a fashion show for breast cancer survivors, which really touched my heart because my mom is actually a breast cancer survivor. I remember when my mom came back from the hospital, I was the first person that she had talked to about getting breast cancer, and that she was stage 3. So the driving force for me to work with the We Believe Foundation was the fact that I had experienced something very similar to what Sarah had experienced, and we knew that we had a higher calling and a bigger mission in life to serve and to help people that have gone through those type of experiences.
Mr. Pham was in 100%. I was shocked. You know, I do a lot of asking and it doesn't usually come that easy. But, you know, what was amazing about him was he never asked what was in it for him. It was always about what could he do for me? What could he do for these young adults? How could he make a difference?
We wanted to put the breast cancer survivors on the runway alongside of professional models. For what I understood in the very beginning, it was going to be a very small scale fashion show. With an expected attendance of 100 people. As the months passed, the event grew in scope and we ended up with 400 people. From what the event began to what the event ended up being, was two different things. And therefore, I had to bring on the dream team to help me carry this event to fruition. And one of the things that I needed was a professional runway coordinator and fashion producer. So enter Rose DiFerdinando from Los Angeles. She had moved back into the area after being in LA for several years, well known for doing LA Fashion Week.
So I got a call from Eddie Pham from Impact Marketing and Events. I immediately said yes. Breast cancer awareness struck home with me. My grandmother, the lady I'm named after, my Roro, is a two-time breast cancer survivor.
And then I contacted a colleague of mine, Sir Andrew Laris, an award-winning international entertainment producer. He's worked with the Washington Redskins doing major events for them, and we needed Andrew behind the scenes.
I was honored, and of course I said yes. You know, having been so fortunate in my career to have done such amazing events all over the world and to be able to travel and meet people and see things that otherwise, without doing what I do for a living, I never would have had the opportunity to do, I feel very fortunate, and so I feel a duty, a responsibility, and a passion for giving back.
Since the theme of the show was faces, I needed to find a way to showcase the faces of these survivals in a way that has never been done before. I actually coordinated a photo shoot for the survivors, and we asked them, you know, take us through your story from diagnosis to survival. And, you know, let this be an area for you to open up again and talk about it and revisit those emotions, because for a lot of these women, it's been years since they've talked about it. Some people laughed, some people cried. It was really important for me to hear every survivor's story, to capture it on film in a vulnerable way, and to use those photos as the faces throughout the entire event.
The event had several surprise elements that we weren't expecting.
We had celebrities who were in attendance who actually knocked on our door saying, can we attend this event? Are there tickets left?
We had the Washington Redskins cheerleaders perform on the runway alongside of their rivals, the Baltimore Ravens cheerleaders. We also had Paul Wharton, who created the MTV show Made. We had international DJ Nicola, who is world-renowned for what she does. We had Janahi, a world-famous poet, that wrote a specific piece for breast cancer survivors that was very touching, and many people's opinion was one of the highlights of the evening.
Kids one day, a $12,000 procedure that insurance does not cover, and one that I don't have the money for, and so I'm left here wondering why this ever had to happen to us. You show them that pain is not the end of things. Remember that you are more than the breasts your mother gave you. Promise me, baby, that I will be seeing you in the morning.
When Janahi's on stage and she's doing this poem, she literally wrote it that morning. And it was because the one she had written, when she showed up on site and saw everything going on behind the scenes, she was moved emotionally to start from scratch. She got a standing ovation, walked off stage, and then I had to shove her back out on the runway to get a second round of applause. And one of the things that, you know, the whole team really thought would be impactful, we wanted to highlight specific survivors. We wanted to give them their moment in the spotlight. They fought this battle, they succeeded, they won. They're champions of this battle and one of the most unthinkable battles you could ever face. And so we had an amazing furniture sponsor. We had lounges in different areas, but they provided us with the certain blocks and different furniture around the room. And we had a great lighting sponsor who provided us with follow spots. So as Janahi is standing there on stage with a completely black room and a spotlight on her, the emotional impact of having eight survivors stand on blocks on the perimeter of the room so that people who are sitting in the audience, they're looking at the stage, they're looking at this survivor, that survivor, back and forth, one at a time, while this emotionally impactful poem is being given, is transcendent. We're bringing our highs up to a very high place where people are laughing, they're jovial, they're enjoying themselves. And when it's time to tug on those heartstrings, we bring that emotion really far down, but we don't let you simmer in that. We don't want that to be the defining moment. We want it to be a moment, absolutely, because this struggle that these people go through is unthinkable. So we bring that emotion down, but we don't sit there. We keep everything upbeat. We bring it back up so that it crescendos in a way that people are brought to their feet. One of the challenges that we faced that was, you know, sort of a scary moment of sorts was right before we opened the doors, we lost power in the ballroom.
So what do you do? We put 5 models on every floor. They're in the hallway, they're in bathrooms, they're in, they're anywhere they need to be where there's an outlet.
You know, we lost sound, video, and lighting. In fact, the ClearCom headsets, you know, the headsets you see all the production personnel behind the scenes wearing, we couldn't communicate with each other.
I had Miss Marilyn opening and closing the show. Curveball, boat week, this is what you have to expect. Miss Marilyn, unfortunately, 30 minutes before the show goes on, gets in a car accident rushing to the show, is sent right to the hospital. Fortunately, she was okay.
We had more VIPs signed up than we actually had space for.
The fact of the matter is, no matter what happens, the doors open at 5 o'clock. So no matter what has to happen between this time and this time, the show must go on.
If any of the guests knew all the crazy stuff that was going on behind the scenes, they would be shocked.
My 3 words that carry me through are fearless, dreams, and my children.
Faith, family, and conqueror.
Laugh, love, and believe.
My 3 words that pull me through were laughter, survival, and love.
So the final part of the video on the show is Paul Wharton, our MTV MC, saying to the audience members.
So awesome. So what are your 3 words?
They have their Polaroid of their face, they have a marker, and bam, it hits them. You know, wow, what are my 3 words?
What the 3 words that really would propel them to survive would be.
My favorite response from one of our attendees was that she and her husband drove home that night, and they discussed the entire way home what their 3 words would be. The emotion that we tried to convey through a fashion show was clearly transcendent and lasted way beyond that evening.
We finally had the opportunity, me, Rose, and Andrew, which I consider the dream team, to work together, and I'm very honored to have worked with both of them, to come together, to put this event together. We learned from each other, we were motivated by each other, and now we are looking to do bigger and better things for the We Believe Foundation and for other nonprofit organizations around the world.
My 3 words would be faith, family, and love.
Laughter, faith, family.
Positivity, family, support.
Impact, hope, God.